Hi, everybody. It's X-Rax, and welcome back to the episode reaction of Black Clover. Today, moving on to 141 and going on from there. Last time, we had more character-centric episodes that focused on their growth as we continue the training, as we move towards the battle against the Spade Kingdom, and I'm very excited for that, guys. We focused last time on Vanessa, who returned home to the Forest of Witches, and she was looking for, you know, a new spell or new abilities, new power to help her friends and herself grow and become stronger. And in the end, it wasn't any type of spell that she learned, but she just learned that she has to have the right mindset. She has to have the right determination to move forward and to push herself forward. And that's what she now plans to do. We also had Sally do some experiments. They're making a magical item. So we had a little bit more with her. We also had then Nozel and Fuegoleon head off to the outskirts of the Forsaken Realm on this little village that hasn't really received any aid from the capital, and they kind of saw how dire things have been for these people. And as I said in my last video, guys, I'm very happy that these captains saw this, and I hope that more captains and more knights and more people see how others are forced to live because they don't get the aid that others are getting. And it's a whole thing, guys, just based off of where you live, where you come from, who you are, all that does not matter. It shouldn't matter, and right now it does. You know, they use the excuse all the time, well, I'm royalty, I'm noble, whatever, but you know, that should not matter. And I really hope that by the end of the show or at some point we start to see that change, you know, for the better. That's what Julius wants, that's what Asta wants, that's what Lumiere wanted, and I'm sure many others as well. So I can't wait, guys, to see what happens next as we continue on. We are still in the midst of training, so we're going to see what happens next, guys, as we move forward. Thank you so much for watching. As always, it means a lot that you're here. If you haven't already, please like this video, please subscribe to the channel for more reactions coming soon, and we do have a Patreon as well where you can help support this channel, so feel free to check it out. The link is in the description below. And thank you to those of you who have already done so. On Patreon, you can view this episode reaction for just $1 a month. It's unedited and unfiltered. Please consider if you can, guys. It means a lot if you do. And without further ado, here we go with episode 141. Let's go.
You know, you and me, we're family, right?
Oh, flashback.
Of course. Not by blood or anything, though.
Right.
But we're closer than a lot of people who are related by blood, aren't we?
I guess so. Why? What's up?
We've got a lot of great friends.
I say, we take all the friends we need, and we make them our family instead.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what they did. So excited, guys. New opening. This is opening 12. Oh my gosh. Once upon a time, I remember watching this for my opening song reaction video. Long time ago. Don't remember the details, though, of what this opening entailed, but it's like all the banners of the different squads hopefully coming together for the sake of the kingdom. There's all the captains. Another catchy one. Asa still has that devil. I'm left wondering, will that come into play? Like, will we ever learn what that devil wants that's with Asta? The threat of the Spade Kingdom, joining the Heart Kingdom. Like, very anticipated, guys, on what's going to be happening next. We're really focusing on the captains, it looks like, in these credits. We see, of course, the flashbacks of them younger, growing up to who they are today. That's an awesome shot. I love that transition. We saw a little earlier, I didn't comment on it, but Yuno was holding his magic stone necklace. Page 141, the Golden Family. Hanging on Asasaur. Ooh, cool. All right, so we have a Golden Dawn-centric episode at the Golden Dawn headquarters. Let's go.
I take it you three are here to give reports to?
Indeed. We just finished a mission in Keaton.
Thank you all for your reports. Klaus, Mimosa, Yuno. The residents of Keaton have expressed their thanks to us again. You obviously did quite well.
Sir.
We're honored to hear that, Captain.
Apparently a herd of wild boars came down from the mountains, posing a threat to Saucy Village. I'd ask another squad to take care of it instead, but no one's available.
I'll do it myself, sir. A few wild boars would be nothing for me.
These aren't normal boars. According to the reports we got from Saucy Village, they're actually magical beasts covered in flames.
Oh.
Villagers are terrified. I'd like you all to go there.
Going back to Saucy Village.
Eliminate the herd before too much damage is done. Alec Dora will lead this mission.
I can't believe the Golden Dawn was sent here to rescue us.
I wish it was the Black Bulls.
Yeah, I want to see Asta again.
You know Asta?
Sure do. Asta, Noelle, and Magna protected our village from some really bad guys.
Long time ago.
That's right. It was a while ago now, but Saucy Village is the place where the Eye of the Midnight Sun was first seen.
Uh-huh.
Oh, man. You guys feel that?
It's the kind of mana that only magical beasts have.
The villagers can't defeat these.
Sheeran, think you can give us a closer look?
Yes, of course. Stone creation magic. Stone model of the world.
If we don't figure out what made them so violent in the first place, the same thing will just happen again.
I see. He does bring up a valid point.
You better learn your place, you know. Lord Vengeance put me in charge of this task, so I should make the decisions.
If defeating the boars was enough, they might
very angry.
How
dare you?
Like,
easy, you know.
He's just upset, but
since you're so confident, you can
this
go
shows
ahead and execute your
bad
plan
leadership
your
qualities,
everyone
not
else, ready yourself
keeping it to
for
yourself
attack.
And blaming
Set.
Others for your
Roger
own
that.
Upset
Who
problems. And
no one hit them.
I don't see this guy advancing
Sorry.
The way he
what
wants
is
to.
Your plan?
I need to find something.
Suppressing sand mass technique.
I'll bet with the right seasonings, these would make a delightful rose.
There.
She's
now
pretty interesting. I like her.
The gambler's fallacy. A one? Too bad. Crescent moon sickle. Steel magic blazing spiral lance.
Up ahead, there's an area with a high magical presence.
Let's take a look.
I think that fruit is what caused all this.
Interesting. So that's why they're on a rampage.
Then we'll need to eradicate all of it along with the trees it's growing on.
Good plan. Thank you, Knights of the Golden Dawn. We are forever in your debt.
Not only did you stop them, but you figured out what was causing them to go berserk.
And now that it's fixed, we shouldn't need to trouble the Magic Knights with this issue again.
I'm glad we could put you at ease. I bet you're really proud of yourself for proving me wrong.
What's with all the flowers?
Oh, they're adorable, don't you think? Since the boars have calmed down, the villagers are keeping a few as their pets.
When you see Asta, tell him I've been working on my spells, okay? Because if he's gonna become the Wizard King, then I want to be on a Magic Knight squad so he and I can work together.
Okay, I'll make sure he knows. But the next Wizard King is actually going to be me.
What? Really?
I wish I could let you relax, but we've just received word that a new dungeon has been discovered.
Oh.
And there seem to be suspicious people inside.
Apparently people have seen Spade Kingdom soldiers fighting in that area. So whatever's happening, Spade is likely involved.
This is a dire situation. Longris, I'd like you to take the lead this time, if possible.
I wish I could be of service to you, Captain, but at the moment I'm still waiting for my injuries to heal. Surely one of the other knights would be up to the task.
Of course. If you think that'd be best, then let's see. I'll send Alec Dora.
Sir, this is my chance. Time to prove once and for all that I'm the one who's the most useful to Lord Vengeance.
During the battle against the Eye of the Midnight Sun, he managed to command magic knights from all over the kingdom with no time to plan. I think he has what it takes to lead. Though, his impertinence can be irritating. What's the matter, sir?
You're different these days. And I mean that in a good way.
I didn't do anything. I just want to make sure this works out.
Yes, that's my goal as well.
I was going to say, this goes a long way for Longris to support somebody else, to say somebody else is good. Like I think that's like something that we've never seen from Longris before, so... He's had some time to reflect on his own mindset and his own actions.
Spade, so this shouldn't be too hard.
Do you want me to get rid of him real quick?
You can leave that to me. I'm going in via the front entrance with Sheeran, Hammond, and Leetwal. That leaves Klaus, Mimosa, David, and... you know. You guys take the top.
Understood.
We'll cut them off here! Take this!
Stone creation magic. Pursuing crushed rock.
What's that do?
Oh.
This dungeon's treasure is ours. You got that?
Don't you know that there's nothing delicious about taking something that isn't yours? Excellent timing.
Aw, man. I tried to get here first so you'd owe me snacks.
Oh, you're already here, eh? I guess I shouldn't have expected too much from a group of low-rate bandits.
You're the only trash I see in here.
And it's bold of you to insult a former senior magic knight. Not that you amateurs would know the difference. I'd watch my tongue.
You have no chance of winning. You'd be wise to cooperate.
Think so, because I have my doubts.
Sand-armored heavy guard!
Sand? Well, that's interesting. It happens to be a perfect match for the spells that I use. Black Earth creation magic. Blood erosion!
Wow.
You're tougher than you look.
Not only does he have the strength to be a magic knight, he's also amplifying his power with a magic item.
Yes, but he's just one man, so we still have the advantage. He has to be aware of that fact.
Dice magic, the gambler's fallacy. My luck's finally turning around now. Unfortunately, I can't say the same for you.
This is the greatest treasure in the whole dungeon. No matter how powerful a spell you cast, I can use this magic item to suck it right up.
Are you kidding me?
Oh.
Bell.
I thought you'd never ask, you know.
Wind magic. Swift white bow.
That felt like a gentle breeze from over here.
Between the necklace and the urn, you've already shown us every trick you've got up your sleeve. And now we can say for certain that you're no match for the Golden Dawn. I should have helped them fight those wild boars. At least that would have been more fun.
I'll absorb all your mana!
Luck's on our side!
Morons, you don't know when to give up, do you? No, it can't be. Damn it, he's persistent.
I'll finish this now! Steel magic blazing spiral lance!
A pitfall? That's what they were planning all along?
Thanks for leaving me with the heavy lifting!
Don't forget, I still have this. You fool! I already told you my type of magic has the advantage over yours!
Not anymore.
Yes, and I told you. You can try, but you're simply no match for the Knights of the Golden Dawn. Alec Dora commanded our team perfectly.
Why are you trying to make me look good?
It's not about
the truth.
And allow me to be honest.
Pushing ahead for the, you know, for the sake of others, like,
our squad looked down on you for being a commoner. They resented you and were jealous.
Like, I don't think Yuno is trying to push somebody down to advance his own ambitions, like this guy wants to do and thinks others are doing to him.
I don't need another reason.
It's all about working together. I think that's the message.
In the past, I was also guilty of thinking someone's low social status made them less worthy of respect. But after being rescued by a commoner with no magic or manners, I reconsidered my prejudices.
Don't you dare compare me to him.
You know, please.
Apologies.
What? Okay, but I'm not sure what you're sorry about.
I wouldn't expect you to understand, but I'd be wrong to let it go unsaid. Even so, I still don't acknowledge you as one of us.
He has to throw that little jab in there, of course. Okay.
When we're finished, let's all go out to eat together.
This is Yuno's chance to bond with the squad.
That sounds wonderful. Hey, come back.
Yuno.
You're invited. In fact, we specifically invited you.
Oh, I didn't.
Hammond knows some great restaurants around the royal capital.
Yeah, we thought it might be fun to hit the town with the whole squad and party.
You and me, we don't have any real relatives. But we've got a lot of great friends. Let's take all the friends we meet and make them our family instead.
Are you coming with us, Yuno?
Hold on, are you blushing?
Of course not.
Looks like you are.
I'm not.
Ooh, I want to see!
I said no.
So I think maybe... I want to talk about these ending credits. I want to watch them. But I do have to say, guys, that maybe you know, right there starts to view his squad as a family, you know, as a real family for him. I don't think to this point he's ever thought that in great detail, maybe. But he probably, you know, has always felt like he's better. Like he doesn't need this training. He doesn't need to be on the squad. He's just better. He should just advance right to the Wizard King because that's how he feels is like how good he is. And he's been put in this place a couple times in the show, I think. And he's learned the hard way, you know, that he does have some growing to do and some training to do and all that. So I think this was a good episode for him to kind of realize all that, to kind of work with your team. You know, if he was alone, I don't think he would have been as successful, but he kind of said it right there in that battle. Like, he didn't say, I have all I need to know to defeat you. He wasn't using I, he was using we. Like, we as a team are better, and we as a team will stop you. And like I said, guys, I think that's the message here. So we're going to go on and see the next one, guys. I can't wait. And if there's a Clover clip, we'll be checking that out first.
The Clover Kingdom. In this place where magic is everywhere.
Oh, is this another intro? New intro?
A magicless boy named Oster. This brave young hero devotes blood, sweat, and tears to becoming the next Wizard King.
Nevertheless, guys, that's a 142.
This situation is practically unheard of. There are others residing in this kingdom who possess at least a tiny amount of mana, yet can barely use spells at all. They make up a very small minority, living their lives in the shadows. They do their best to survive.
So I'm assuming we're going to meet the people they alluded to?
Place just before the Eye of the Midnight Sun attacked the royal capital.
Oh, okay.
The setting is a town that was neither rich nor poor, neither large nor small. Just an ordinary place. Located somewhere within the common realm.
No. Try to be strong. It should heal up quickly.
I should go now.
No one will be here for a while. You're very welcome to stay.
I would love to, but he'll be coming back home soon.
I see.
Well, goodbye.
See you later.
Jeez. Magic for everything. I'm assuming she is one of the people that maybe has little to no magic, like Asta.
Another great meal. You know, thanks a lot, Doc.
Barely has any.
Of course.
Like they kind of alluded to.
It really is delicious. You're a wonderful.
She's the only one not using magic to eat.
Got that right.
Oh, dear. What a shame we were sitting here talking so long that my soup seems to have gotten cold.
Sorry, I'll go reheat it for you.
There's no need to walk all the way to the kitchen. It'll be much easier to warm it up with your magic.
I'll need your flame magic, Mother, and I hope you won't mind lending me your spatial magic as well, dear.
Thank you. That's much better. That catalyst magic of yours really does come in handy.
I wish I could borrow other people's magic.
Catalyst
for my
magic.
Own purposes.
Okay.
That's a valuable skill.
Oh, jeez. We saw this hideout, like, traveling. We never got to see like just the devastation it really truly caused. We focus that episode in Hajj Village, just little glimpses, but like this is interesting to see just the true devastation of the random citizen, what they had to deal with. Wow. So I'm assuming family dies. We don't know what he said to her.
Curse you, human.
Jeez. Like, I know it was a lot of episodes, but the whole thing with the elves, I feel like, happened overnight. It happened, like, in one day's, time span for these people. Most people probably have no idea what actually happened, and they're finding out later after the fact that there was an invasion, there were elves, all this stuff. Like, it's kind of crazy and interesting to think about.
Is something wrong?
Read this.
The Devil's Servants? It says members of the Magic Knights were recently suspected of communicating with the Devil and using forbidden spells. The accused will soon face trial by the Magic Parliament.
The only reason they did all of those terrible things was because a powerful Devil assumed possession of their bodies, somehow.
What? They were possessed? A Devil?
We only have 6 months, but please do everything possible to raise their stages.
The whole tone of this episode, guys, is so different.
Protect the residents of Hart, as well as our own land.
I feel like we're starting something new here.
Does this arrangement work for you?
I suppose I don't object.
What is the meaning of this? Asta of the Black Bulls? And that damned Nero woman? They're servants of the Devil. We can't let them roam free for 6 months!
As I explained before, what matters right now is that we cooperate with the Heart Kingdom and the Magic Knights. It's crucial that we maintain a unified front in the face of that Devil and the Spade Kingdom.
Sir!
It's already decided.
There are many parties to blame for what the Eye of the Midnight Sun did to our kingdom, but that Devil was at the root of it all! They killed my nephew, sir!
Enough.
I'm sorry, sir, but we need to put these vicious criminals to death! It's the only way for us to protect our people! The Magic Parliament is supposed to be...
Silence!
Right. I'll take my leave. The scales of justice have tipped into the darkness. It's up to me to bring them back into the light for the sake of the Clover Kingdom.
Is that him?
Yes, I'm certain of it. He hates the Devil more than anyone else in the Magic Parliament.
Then let's go. Are you Cowboy, by chance?
Yes, my name is Cowboy. I'm sorry, but do I know you?
No, we haven't had the pleasure. We were hoping you could spare some time to talk.
Actually, I'm a little busy right now.
I lost my family when the Eye of the Midnight Sun attacked our village. And not just them. Many lives were lost.
We're looking for revenge for all the victims. And we're going to need your help to achieve it.
You want me to help? What do you intend to do?
My intent, or ours rather, is to destroy the Devil's Servants with our own hands.
The Devil's Servants?
So, murder?
Are you serious? I'll need to hear your plans in a bit more detail.
In the wake of the Eye of the Midnight Sun's attack, order was returning to the capital. Wizard King Julius Novacrono was swamped with paperwork from the rebuilding effort. Meanwhile, the Magic Knight squads each engaged in their own vigorous training regiments, in preparation for their coming battles with the Spade Kingdom and the Devil.
A little water would be pretty good right now. Why don't we take a break for a while?
But I'm not thirsty at all, though.
I say it's time for a water break, and I'm royalty, so I'm right!
You're always bringing that up. What does you being royalty have to do with anything either way?
I said I need a break, so I'm gonna take a break, okay? If you're not thirsty, then don't come with me, idiot.
I'm not sure what she's getting so mad at me for. Do you know?
Nope.
Ah, well, might as well work out then, huh? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6...
It's quieter than usual.
That's because everybody's been out there training, except for Henry.
They had to help train this miscreant. With that done, now I'm off to keep watch over my perfect angel.
Keeping watch, is that what you call it?
Man, I'm beat! We could make a great combo spell with my spatial magic and his mirror magic, but the timing's been crazy hard to nail down.
I have to cleanse the filth from my body before I see my angel.
Sister Teresa doesn't come back from her trip till tonight. There was some big meeting for all the sisters in the church. So I guess Gosh wants to go visit Marie before she gets home. And apparently I'm the lucky one who gets to go with them.
We'll be together again soon, Marie.
I was gonna say Gordon's gotta be in here.
Gosh, will you need some help washing your back? And after that, you can help me wash my back as well.
1090, 1091, 1092, 1093, 1094, 1095, 1096, 1097!
How long can he keep doing that? He's already been at it for a while. He must be starting to get hungry. I'm not a cook, but I know I can at least make a sandwich.
There. That must be her. Indeed. Marie Adlai, daughter of a disgraced noble. Her brother is a former criminal.
And she herself was possessed by a devil. She caused grave harm to many innocent people in the attack.
We need to take care of this before the old hag from the church returns. Come with me, servant of the devil. You brat!
Just what do you think you're trying to pull?
You were gonna try and grab her!
We're not gonna let anybody take our friend!
That's right! Back off!
Damn kids!
Who are these people? I'll go get help!
Who are you guys?
Good to see this guy again.
He's scared!
Remember the name.
We Niche,
are
I think?
The devil banishers.
Step back. I won't let anyone lay their hands on these kids. No magic! Ghosts, no cry!
There's one behind me? Why didn't I sense any mana?
Because they barely have it.
Nish! Stop! Get off! Let me go!
You won't be escaping again, servant of the devil.
Someone contact the Magic Knights, now!
Let's go.
No, Marie. Leave her alone.
Marie, no!
Wait, please! Someone, help me, please! Please, Gosh! Save me!
What's wrong?
I could have sworn I heard an angel calling out to me just now.
Oh, hearing things now?
Nap time is over. Let's go.
Whatever. It's like none of you even know what the word seniority means.
How long do you plan to be out here?
Until we get to 10,000! 81! 82! Wait, no. You distracted me with your question! I totally lost count! Now I have to start over from the beginning or I'll cut the workout short! 1, 2!
Oh man, they're here too.
5, 36! What? Is she alone? Hang on! Stay with me. What happened?
Please, take this.
That was impressive. You're quite a skilled potion maker.
Thank you.
I had only counted on capturing the devil's servant, but it seems we found the forbidden magic girl as well.
Ow! Let go!
How can he be that strong?
Can't stay conscious.
Nero, let her go.
Please help me, Busta.
What do you people think you're doing?
Sealing magic. Inverse release.
Can't move my body.
Was that the thing Damnatio put on him originally? Or no, I'm sorry, that was Fuegoleon put on him to, like, track him? I don't know. I think so. Look at that! Let's go.
There's no choice. Leave him.
I agree.
Please, forgive me.
Transparency magic. Share the same fate.
Don't you dare leave without telling me who you are!
We are the Devil Banishers.
We will drive the devil to its demise.
You won't get away! Not until Nero is safe!
What is all this?
Gosh! They took Marie! You have to help her!
Asta, please wake up! Asta!
Oh, man. Well, this is unexpected, guys. I feel like I've been just having the character-centric episodes just back one after another kind of thing, back to back, and this didn't seem to be the case. This seems like to be a whole new story, a whole new arc and new thing happening here, and I'm very intrigued where we go from here with it. You know, it's been a while since we've had any kind of cliffhanger episode ending, so you know, time will tell, guys, with what's going to actually happen. I'm curious to know how long this arc is going to run for. You know, like, I don't know, guys. I'm totally in the dark here. I have no idea what to expect next. But like I said, I'm very intrigued. I feel like, you know, everyone's training. Everyone's doing their thing. Like, this, you know, getting Marie back, getting Secker back, like, all that is going to do so much more for the characters as far as training goes, rather than just battling and sparring with each other. You know, a real threat where they're not holding back, where they're trying to, you know, succeed in a mission, life or death or whatever. Like, I feel like that is going to do so much more than anything else they do with each other. So I'm so sorry, guys, I talked all over it, but I wanted to mention that I was told this ending credits was sung by the voice actor of Asta, the Japanese voice actor, so very cool.
You can't die, Asta. Wake up! Make one of your dumb faces and laugh that stupid laugh of yours! Black Clover, page 143, the tilted scale. They took Nero and Marie. What is it they're after?
And that is the question. What are they after? We're going to see Damnatio again, it looks like, and learn a little bit more about these devil vanishers trying to eliminate the devils. Obviously, they're just taking it upon themselves because they're unhappy with the decisions by the bigwigs. So is Damnatio going to aid the Black Bulls and the Knights in stopping them, even though he kind of wants the same thing? I don't know. I'm going to be left wondering that, guys, as we move forward with the next episode. So thank you so much, as always, for joining me. It means a lot that you're here. If you haven't already, please like this video. Please subscribe. And definitely drop a comment down below. Let me know what you thought of this episode and this reaction. I always love to chat with you guys about it. Like I said, guys, we'll be back every Wednesday for more reactions of Black Clover. So stay tuned. Thanks again for watching. Have a great one, and we will see you next time.